In Pali, the original language of the Buddha, there are four interrelated words called Buddhi, Bodha, Bodhi, and Buddha. Buddhi is a neuter noun. Generally, in the modern terms, it is translated as intelligence. That intelligence is more worldly than superworldly, or more mundane than supramundane. Then there is a supramundane intelligence called Bodhi, the capacity, the latent capacity to be enlightened. Then there is another word called Bodha. Bodha means understanding with the help of that latent capacity called Bodhi, the supramundane wisdom, understanding. Then there is another word called Buddha. Buddha is a past participle noun. It grammatically means understood, and it is personified as Buddha, the one who has understood. Here, understood means understood the reality or the truth. The Buddha is named so because he has understood the truth of the reality that we experience. The reality about ourselves and the reality of the world or the universe in which we live. The basic reality he realized through his wisdom is called Anicca Dukkha Anatta. Here, understanding means seeing by the inner eye called insight. Buddha had an insight into the real nature of the nature. And the basic nature he saw in the nature is called Dukkha. Etymologically, it means transformation. In the modern sense, it is a transformation of energy. Energy is the creative power of the universe, but the Buddha saw it through his insight not as a power, but as an activity that we can call in the modern sense creativity of the universe that is prevalent everywhere, every time. And that creativity is produced by the universal energy according to the modern science. But according to the Buddha, energy and the creativity are one and the same. There is no thing called energy, permanent thing called energy, because he saw the basic nature of the universe as impermanent. And there's a creativity. And that creative power of the universe in constant action leads to constant transformation. It is that transformation of energy that was called Dukkha. Due to this constant transformation of each and every item in the universe, no item, whether animate or inanimate, cannot retain a permanent identity. that can be considered as a permanent self, believed in many other religions. Buddha said there is no permanent self anywhere in the universe. Therefore, non-availability of a permanent identity is called anattata. It amounts to the non-existence of a creative God. Buddha saw a creativity, but there was no creator that the Buddha could see in the universe. Buddha, seeing this triple nature of nature by his insight, revealed to us four aspects of this transmission of universal energy called dukkha. The cause of transmission is the creativity, the energy called creativity. The result of that transformation is the non-availability of a permanent identity called soul anywhere. And in this dukkha, Buddha explained, and Buddha saw through his insight at the enlightenment, four aspects that is generally termed as the four noble truths. Those truths are called noble because those who become sublime by enlightenment can see that reality, and one becomes sublime, enlightened one, by having an insight into the four aspects of this nature. The first aspect is dukkha, the transformation. And dukkha samudaya means the cause of transformation. Dukkha nirodha means the ending or cessation of transformation. And dukkha nirodha gamini patapada means the path or the technique or the method or the way leading to the cessation of suffering. He referred to a mental state called our mental suffering as dukkha dukkha. The transmission of that energy or that state was called viparinama dukkha. And the basis of the mental transformation he referred to as sankhara dukkha. Sankhara means thinking. At the enlightenment, what happened was thinking stopped. That is why in his first paean of joy he uttered visankhara gatam cittam. The thinking process of the mind stopped. The mind has two activities. One is thinking, the other is sensing. Through sense organs, the mind can sense different items. And whenever there is a sensation of an item, the mind naturally starts thinking. Thinking starts with liking, disliking, or ignorance. We think of things that we like, we think of things that we dislike, we think of things that we can really understand or comprehend or see, that is called ignorance. In Buddhist terms, they are referred to as lobha, dosa, moha. Enlightenment means the cessation of lobha, dosa, moha. No likes, no dislikes, no ignorance. Likes means attachment. When we like something, we get attached to it. when you dislike a thing, we resent it. Liking and disliking, or getting attached, or being resentful is dependent on the ignorance of our mind to see the reality of things in the universe. And seeing this reality is called the right vision, or it may be called in the path to Nirvana, the Eightfold Path, as right understanding, called Sammaditti. Ditti means seeing. Samma means seeing the reality. Mitya means mitya, a myth, non-reality. Seeing an illusion. Even Brahmanism and Hinduism refer to the illusion of the world that we experience. And even modern science accepts the fact that none of our sense organs can see the reality or experience the reality of the reality inside or outside us, because our visions of the eye are limited. The hearing of the ears are limited. The taste that the tongue can do is also limited. We can experience only limited taste. We can experience only limited smells. We can't smell what the dogs can smell, but by their very sensitive nose. And your mind is limited because minds can think only with the help of memories stored in it, and now memories are very limited. Seeing things beyond our knowledge can be called Buddha vision. Buddha vision means an enlightened vision. Enlightened means the dispelling of the darkness hiding the reality of things. The reality of things, the Buddha realized, as I said at the beginning, was anicchata, dukkata and anattata. In short, the universal dynamism, which means we cannot hold on to anything, even to our life. Things are ever changing. This is a fact revealed even by the Greek philosophers that lived during the time of the Buddha in the 5th century. One Greek philosopher called Heraclitus said, "No one can step into the same river twice, because there is a flux in everything." Buddha was revealing this truth to the world, not as a scientist, but as a religious director directing the human beings in the correct path. We are suffering in this world by being attached to things and by being resenting things. When you know the reality, things are ever changing, we know that there is no point in being attached to anything. When we know things are changing, we have no need to hate or resent things that we dislike. They too may vanish. And the realization of this truth, or seeing this truth, can be called the real Buddha vision, and who has at least a little amount of this vision awakened can be called a Buddhist, a one with Buddhi called wisdom, or a wise one. Buddhist means a wise one who can see the reality and the real nature of the reality.